Chants and cheers outside of the U.S. Supreme Court after justices ruled to uphold the rights of Dreamers, allowing some 700,000 young immigrants to continue living and working in what for many is the only country they've ever called home.
I'm elated. We win. And so I'm honored to be here today at the Supreme Court and ready to keep fighting for more.
It's allowed me to go to college. It's allowed me to get a full-time job. That could have all been stripped away had the court decided differently today.
In the 5-4 vote, Chief Justice John Roberts sided with the court's four liberal members, ruling that the Trump administration's given reasons for ending the program were, quote, arbitrary and capricious. DACA, which stands for Deferred Action for Childhood Arrivals, gives deportation protection and working rights to people under 30 who were brought to the U.S. illegally as children. The program was put in place in 2012 under Barack Obama, and Donald Trump sought to end it less than 8 months after taking office. It was the second time this week the Supreme Court has gone against the Trump administration's will after a ruling Monday that deemed it illegal to fire someone for being gay or transgender.
These horrible and politically charged decisions coming out of the Supreme Court are shotgun blasts into the face of people that are proud to call themselves Republicans or conservatives. We need more justices or we lose our Second Amendment and everything else. Vote Trump 2020.
While Trump won the 2016 election on an anti-immigration platform, polls show that DACA has widespread public support. A recent survey from Pew Research Center found that over 90% of Democrats and just over half of Republicans support legal protections for Dreamers.